What did you think of it? I mean, let's give credit to Jordan.
Indeed.
For a start,
they
played this smartly. Their coach certainly did.
They were
so
better.
Credit to them.
Mm. They were better than us today, and they really played it perfectly. You know, Australia went in with a midfield that was built to control the game, and we didn't control the game, which means that you don't have the defensive aspect, and all of a sudden that they're in control, you can't get the ball. So, you know, you have to play to the type of team that you put out. And to me, that team was one that had to get hold of the ball and had to be in control, because in the centre of midfield there, both Matty Mackay and Bresciano are not defensive midfielders. So that's very clear. It didn't happen. But OK, when that happens, then you realise that they're on top of us, they're in control, we've got to go on the counter-attack. We didn't do that well. I think the penalty was giveable. You make contact with him in the box and it is a potential penalty. He makes the most of it. Technically speaking, it is not a penalty because I don't think the contact is enough to send him to ground. But let's be clear on this. The referee is some way away. He makes contact. He then takes advantage of the contact and it's a penalty. But the real issue for us was, once this happened, they then sat back, and that's our only period where we started to pass the ball. But you can really get into this situation where you leave yourself open at the back. And at 1-0 down, you have to be incredibly careful of getting hit on the counter-attack. And the one thing in the game that I think is most... that we can be most incensed about or disappointed about is this. That you are away from home, you're 1-0 down, you have plenty of time left in the game, and these guys are experienced enough to know that you do not leave yourself 3-v-2 at the back, away from home in a game that you have to get something out of. And when I see that 3-v-2, I just think, you know, we're just sitting here in disbelief going, you can't have done that. We can't have done that, you know. So they played it very well. You know, Lucas went to ground. He did very well to get past him. And there was a beautiful little ball into the near post. So, all right, now you're in a lot of trouble. Then we had some chances, but as did they.
Yeah.
Okay. And arguably he should have finished that. So they were better than us today, without question. We really didn't get anything right that we went into the game with. And in the end, we resorted then to pumping the ball into the box. This was a nice bit of play. This was one of the few little combinations.
We didn't see it enough.
Where someone's coming off. Archie's done really beautifully here. He's played the ball around the corner, a little blind pass, and followed his pass. And they've played it well between him and Broski. Then it's desperate measures late in the game, and we have a couple of half chances.
Yeah.
You know, if you finish that, okay, you know, we're all praying here because at least you get out.
Yeah.
You've been outplayed, but if you can get out with a draw, all the better.
You'll take it.
Now, you know, you're in a situation of real stress, and the next game becomes absolutely critical. I'm sure we'll go to that table. It's not panic stations, because when you look at what's going to happen in the next few games,
it'll all change.
You know, there's because what'll happen in the next game, even if you get a point out of that one, you'll see Jordan are very up and down. So Jordan, it's always going to be a race now for the second spot. Australia's got 3 of the last 4 games at home. Okay, but the concern is the way that we're actually playing at present. Right? But qualification is still very much on the table. But the game next month, away to Iraq. Wow, what pressure that is now.
All right, let's hear now from the national coach Holger Ozic. See how he has responded to this result.
Well, I mean, right now it's very difficult to describe. The disappointment is enormous and. We had a very, very poor first half. We didn't get into the game. Our passing was a disaster. We never could get into our normal rhythm. In fact, we played a lot of long balls. I don't know why that happened. There was not enough movement in midfield. It was definitely a very poor football we showed in the first half. And then second half, of course, we tried very hard. We could have scored, but when we can't capitalize from those opportunities, then you cannot blame anybody else but us.
Have you let the players know of your disappointment in no uncertain terms?
Well, a couple of words have been said already in the dressing room.
Wonder what those words were, Zdrilla. Yeah. Your response to the way Holger summed this up?
Well, you even saw on the sideline he was very animated, very, you know, he was very angry during the whole game. But, yeah, it was interesting him saying that a lot of long balls. He doesn't know why they're doing that, but it seems to happen quite often in games where they resort to these long balls. And the passing, I agree, was not there. They couldn't get into midfield, they just couldn't. The fluency wasn't there. Jordan played better, and there's a lot of pressure on the next game.
They usually resort to those long balls when they run out of ideas. Foz, just very quickly, we haven't got too much time left. Looking ahead, what needs to be paid attention to?
There is time left, and it was always going to, given our slow start, it was always going to come down to the last couple of games here in Australia. That's key. And at home, Australia's very strong. There are issues around the way that we're playing, and I think Ozzy's just talked about them, but they've been there for quite some time now, a couple of years, particularly with this going in the air and direct. The next game is critical. You must get at least a point. Jordan are on 4. Okay, that puts Australia on 3. That leaves Iraq where they are. Japan have a bye in the next round. Then all of a sudden you get a win, and now you're starting to get back into second spot. So the situation is, well, you could say it's critical, but it's not terminal. Right,
it's not as bad as it might seem.
No, because
there is time.
Back end is much better for us than the front end. Yeah. But that can't happen.
But you're going into it with a lot of pressure. That's the problem.
Yeah.